this video I am going to share two secret methods which were proven in last grade B exam, and today I'll share with you. I hope you'll get benefited from this. Watch the complete video to get the secret methods. First, you have to open the Reserve Bank of India's website, that is rbi.org.in, and then this is the Reserve Bank of India's website, and on this website you have to scroll it down and go to the last at the bottom, and on the left hand side of the corner there is this FAQ. So we have to select this FAQ, or we have to click on this FAQ. Once you will click on this FAQ, this page will appear, this frequently asked question. So here you can see that these FAQs pertaining to various departments of Reserve Bank of India are given, various functions. Say for banking, if I click, so these are the different topics pertaining to which FAQs can be seen. See this in the banking ombudsman, you can see these are the different type of questions which anybody can ask you pertaining to banking ombudsman. So these kind of almost all the questions related to banking ombudsman are given here. Like which banks comes under banking ombudsman scheme, and these are the complaints which banking ombudsman can handle, and when can one file a complaint. This is the question which was asked 2 years back. So this is the answer. So if you have read these FAQs, then you would be able to recall, and you will be able to answer these questions efficiently. These questions, these FAQs will not only help you in part 1 but also part 2. And I'll tell you the other method which is also proven, that I'll subsequently tell. So first see this first method, and agony of harassment, to up to 1 lakh rupees a person can claim, and banking ombudsman can get him up to 1 lakh rupees for harassment. So here I am highlighting some of the important questions, like up to what amount the banking ombudsman can award. So this is 20 lakh rupees or 2 million, up to 2 million rupees the banking ombudsman can provide the compensation. The award can be up to 2 million. So almost all these questions, it will take you hardly 5-6 hours to go through all these MCQs. And you should read these MCQs as of now, and at least 1 week before the exam or during the revision of the exam. So these are the related to banking ombudsman related question, and there were other old more topics in banking. So you have to read all the FAQs on all the topics pertaining to banking. Then these are the different topics pertaining to foreign exchange. Here you can see which are the different topics which you want to read. You should read all the topics. Now if you select that who is an NRI, and these are the different kind of questions which I'll suggest you to read. And generally many a time you find that direct MCQs are asked from these FAQs, in not only in phase 1 but phase 2 also. So I have received many emails where people thanked me for my previous video in phase 1, where I suggested them to go through this. And in this video I am giving one more additional feature which I missed, and which people told me that I should also have recommended that in my secret methods. Then these are the different kind of FAQs pertaining to NBFCs, especially NDSIs companies, and you can see all these FAQs, then payment and settlement system related questions. What is RTGS? So you can get all the information related to RTGS. Many times we feel that we know everything about RTGS and NEFT, but there are questions which are very confusing kind of questions, and the right answer we are not aware of. So if you read these FAQs, and these are coming from direct horse's mouths, so the chances of any wrong information is very minimal. And I'll say that there is 0% chance that these information would be wrong, because Reserve Bank continuously keep updating these FAQs as and when there is any change in the policy. Now we'll move to our second important method, which is very important and which helps not only in part 1 but in part 2 also. So this is the PPI instrument. So these are the some of the questions pertaining to PPI. So I'm just showing you different kind of FAQs which are directly, you'll see that the questions were asked from these FAQs in previous exams. Very important topic, you should not avoid it. And then we will move to our second section. So first we'll go to home, and then you have to click on the publications. When you click on the publication, you have to go to annual publication. Here comes the annual report. In last exam, 5 questions were directly from this section, which I'm just going to show you. No need to mug up all the GK questions. You have to focus on these questions, then you can easily get good marks. And here what you have to do, you have to open this annual balance sheet, and then you have to go to the scroll down, and after this table which they have given, table of index, this comes the select abbreviations. So these abbreviations are directly asked in the exam part 1 phase 1. Directly they ask these abbreviation, and you can answer these abbreviations directly if you have read these abbreviations one or twice. And these are the direct questions are asked. You have to give just one or two readings of these FAQs, and then your job is done. They are prime important, you should not leave them. And then other than these FAQs, there is one more thing that you have to read in the balance sheet, which is that this chronology of major policy announcements. This is on page number 228. So we'll go on page number 228 and we'll see. This section is also very important, that chronology of this. In this section, you'll get to know various policies, various guidelines issued by Reserve Bank of India during the year. So you should not leave this section also. Here you can see that date wise they have given pertaining to different department, like pertaining to monetary policy department, which they have given. So these are very important topics, and I'll suggest you to read all these things. Then on the RBI's website also, go to RBI's website, click on the home. Here you can see the policy rates. So these policy rates you should read just before the exam, because these policy rates, they keep changing. So you should be updated. So you should read just before the exam. Then here the reference rate, CR and SLR, that you can also see. And there we have a lot of study material on our website, on our YouTube channel. You can watch them, like, subscribe and comment.